Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to check the Roma F1, a new micro quadcopter by Daton. In this video, I'm going to quickly go over its features and specs and test it with and without the included propeller guards. In terms of packaging, the F1 comes inside a high quality Daton branded carrying case, where inside, along with the quadcopter, you're getting 4 pretty flexible and durable propeller guards. You're also getting a USB to USB Type-C cable for connecting the flight controller to your computer. The user manuals and wiring diagrams of the flight controller, ESC, radio receiver and VTX. The assembly diagram of the Roma F1 frame, which is available separately. Joystick connectors for connecting a radio receiver to the flight controller. A small keychain, which in case for some reason you'd like to, you can attach to the quadcopter. 2 high-quality 12 and 11 cm long battery Velcro straps, spare screws, spare pieces of tape for securing the motor wires, an external buzzer, and a spare battery pad. As for its specs, the Daton Roma F1 features the Mamba Tocca 1103 10,000 kV motors, which can handle up to 3S batteries when pushing these included Genfen 1636 propellers. The motors and propellers are protected using removable plastic molded injection propeller guards. On the center of the quadcopter, you can find a stack which supports up to 4S batteries and is based on a 25A BLLES 4-in-1 ESC, an F4 flight controller that features a USB Type-C connector, and on the top of the stack, you can find a board that accommodates both the Mamba TX500 VTX that supports IRC tram protocol and has a selectable output power of 25, 200 and 500 milliwatts, and the Mamba MSR, an FR Sky D16 compatible radio receiver. On the front of the quadcopter, protected between 2 aluminum side plates, you can find the Runcam Nano 2 nano-sized FPV camera. A linear antenna is secured on the back of the frame using a 3D printed TPU part, which also secures the battery leads of an XT30 battery connector, and the battery is supposed to be mounted on the top plate, although if you'd like to use the F1 with a bigger battery, you can also mount it on the bottom of the frame. In case you're going to remove the propeller guards, make sure to use shorter screws, as otherwise you are going to damage the motors. As for the frame, its wheelbase is 85mm and it features a wide X pattern. The thickness of the bottom unibody plate is 2.5 mm, the thickness of the top plate is 2 mm, and the weight of the F1 without a battery is 72.6 grams. In addition, removing the propeller guards is going to reduce the weight of the F1 to 65.1 grams and will enable you to use it with 2-inch propellers. As for setting it up, first of all, in order to connect the flight controller to your computer, you will need to obtain this type of USB Type-C adapter, as otherwise you won't be able to access the USB Type-C connector, which is blocked by the propeller guards, or in case you don't have one of these adapters, you will need to remove these 2 propeller guards. Binding the Mamba MSR radio receiver is done using FR Sky D16 protocol, and entering bind mode is done by pressing the bind button on the radio receiver while powering up the quadcopter. Here is a quick overview of the stock Betaflight settings, which are linked down below. The bidirectional D-Shot switch is enabled, as the 4-in-1 ESC is pre-flashed with Jazz Maverick 16.9 firmware. In addition, the F1 is pre-tuned, and out of the box, the maximum output power of the VTX can be set to 25mW, so in order to use the 200 and 500mW options, you will need to add these values to the VTX configuration tab. The next thing that I've done is to head outdoors and test the Daton Roma F1. Overall, after testing it out, I can tell you that in my opinion, it's a pretty little cute micro quadcopter that is suitable both for beginner and advanced pilots. It is relatively quiet and its form factor makes it not intimidating. In case you are a beginner or you'd like to fly the F1 indoors, I recommend to use the propeller guards, which are going to damage the acrobatic performance of the F1 and slightly reduce the flight time. And as you advance, or if you're already an advanced pilot, I recommend to remove the propeller guards, and preferably use 2-inch propellers, which are going to make the F1 a nice little racer. As for flight time, using a GNB 300mAh 3S LHV battery, which sits nicely on the top plate of the F1, you can expect between 2 to 3 minutes using the propeller guards and between 3 to 4 minutes without them, of course depending on how you fly. And as for durability, which is very important, especially if you're a beginner, but not only, I think that the F1 is pretty durable. The camera is nicely protected using the side aluminum plate, and I think that even without the propeller guards, the F1 will be able to withstand some nasty crashes. Anyway, that's going to be it for my quick review of the Datton Roma F1, and now I'm going to wrap up this video with some flight footage. As always, I thank you for watching my video, I hope you enjoyed it and you find it useful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments section down below. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up if you like this video and consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notifications bell if you're not already subscribed. See you on my next videos and goodbye.